Alright, so I've been asked to do this video because apparently every other video is telling people to use some sort of add-in. So I'm going to show you how we can generate QR codes for whatever type of data you have. Right now I'm going to use this hyperlinks. So we're going to need to do a little bit of VBA code for this, but fortunately it's not really going to be that much. So even if you're not a coder, you should be able to follow. So what we do need, we need to get to this website, goqr.me/API. I will link to this website underneath the video if you want to get to it. So here, if you look through it, there is this hyperlink that it shows us as an example. And if I click on this, it will basically just show us, if we go to this URL, it will generate this QR code for us. And that's exactly what we need. So we need to copy this link for this QR code, go to our file, and for now, I'm not gonna use this data yet. I'm gonna go to a different tab. For now, I'll just paste that link here. And if you look in this link, there is the actual hyperlink for this. And then we have some parameters like the size of this. So you can see it's 150 on 150. And then there is the data that says equals example. So what we need to do, if you want to replace it to be a different size, you would update that 150 by 150 part to do a different size. And then finally, we need to update this example with our data. So in my case, that's going to be those URLs. In your case, it could be whatever you want this to be. For the time being, I'm going to leave this link alone and I'll make another tab. What we're going to do here first, we need to basically just size some rows here. So I'll highlight a bunch of rows and resize them. Let's say this size and this size. So this is where your QR code is going to go. Now, what you want to do at this point is do a little macro recording. So to record a macro, you need this developer tab. If you don't already have it activated, you can go under file, go under options. And under options, if you go to customize ribbon, you will see there's this checkbox for developer. For me, it's already checked. There's nothing I have to do. If you don't have it, just check the box, hit okay. You should have this tab. Now, all I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna just do a quick recording to add a picture to the cell. So what I'll do, I'll click in the cell, go to developer, go to record macro, and I'll just keep it macro one, that's fine. I wanna make sure this stores it in this current workbook, this workbook. I'm gonna hit okay, and now we're recording. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna go under insert, go under pictures, and basically just add a picture here, and any picture you wanna choose from your computer at this point. So I'll just grab this picture, hit insert, and as you can see, that adds the picture. Now the important part here is to resize now this picture for the cell. So I'm going to go from this right side first and resize it to the cell like this. So you wanna try to do this with one shot and take the second and resize it to this. Don't worry if your picture doesn't look good. So once I have this picture in the cell, I've recorded this macro. All I'm gonna do now is stop this recording. So I'll go under developer, stop recording. And now if I go under macros, I should see that macro and I click edit, that should take me to the code that was recorded to basically generate that particular picture. So here for any of this active window scrolls, I'm gonna get rid of those. We're not gonna need that. You'll see we do have this link for that picture. Now what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna go on top here and I'll just create a file path variable and I'll make it equal. I'll do double quotes and I'll just basically just copy this and paste it right here. And then over here within this parentheses, I'll just replace it with this variable file path. And I should probably type that correctly here. Like that. So file path here, file path here. So now with this code, I'm gonna do a couple of small customizations. What I'm going to do, I'm going to add a width block for this. So right here, we'll do width like this. Remove this select and dot out of here. And then we'll go below this whole thing and do end that width block like this. And then over here, we don't need the selection anymore. We're just going to do dot whatever we have like this. So that's a little customization I'm going to do here. I'm going to remove this comments just so that this code is a little smaller. So now we want to try what's going to happen if we replace this path with that path that we had from that link. So I'm going to go grab that link. So I had it over here. So I'll just copy this. Go back to that Visual Basic. You can either click Visual Basic or go back to Macros and click Edit, whichever works for you. I'm going to go back here and basically just remove this and paste our other link. So at this point, we want to make sure that this actually works the way it's supposed to, because if we need to resize this, we better do it now. So for me, it's 150 on 150. I'm going to leave it at that. If you want to change it, like I said, make sure you change both. So both height and width should be the same for your QR code. So let's go to the sheet 3, delete the picture we already have, click in one of these cells, go to macros, and this time I'm going to click on this and run this macro. And it may take a little bit because it needs to go get that picture out of there. And you can see we got the picture, we placed it in the cell, but the size is a lot smaller than what I need. So now I need to adjust my code to get this size to be the correct size for this. So I'm going to get rid of it, go to Visual Basic. Now, because the picture was smaller than what I need to basically make this scale larger. If it was the opposite, you would pretty much do the opposite. I'm literally just going to try to do something like 1.25. And I'll use that same scale here. Let's try this again and see what happens. So I'm going to go under macros, rerun this thing. So as you can see, that was too big. So we basically have to experiment until we get this to the right size. So I'll just go back here. We could do some other things, but this is probably going to be the easiest thing to do. So I'll try 0.75 this time. So that's a lot better. As you can see, we can resize it a little greater to get it to where we need this to be. So once you play around with this and get it to the size you actually want, now we're ready to finalize our code to generate a bunch of QR codes instead of just one, and to actually use the data we need. Now, the way I'm going to do this, I'm going to make it happen in a way that if we go here and select like this much, we'll basically just put our QR codes right next to it, to the right. So basically, whatever data you select, that's what we're going to use to actually generate QR codes. So let me just resize this really quickly here. So I'll select all of these rows, resize these to give it some space for those QR codes that I'm going to put here. And for now, for just testing, I'll highlight two of these. We'll go back to our Visual Basic, and we're going to have to do a little bit of adjustment here. What we need to do, we need to basically loop through that selection that we highlighted. And for that, we'll go above this code that we've done, and we'll do for each cell in selection. And then we'll go below all of this code, and then we'll do next cell, which is this variable right here. So this will now allow us to loop through our selected cells and run this code over and over again for all the cells. So what I'm going to do instead of this example here, I'm going to remove that example part, keep the equal sign, and then I'm going to follow this with ampersand to join the value in that cell. So cell.value. And that would refer to the actual hyperlink right now that's in the cell. So this way, we're basically adding dynamically that data part to this. So that's good. Now, once we get that, we want to insert that right next to it in this next column to the right. So what I'll do, I'm gonna go in this for each loop and we're gonna select that cell. So I'm gonna go here and do cell.offset 0, 1.select. So what this means is that from the cell that was selected, which would be one of these cells over here, right? We wanna go same row, so 0 offset for rows, and 1 column right. So that would be 1. If you wanted to go 2 column right, you would do 2. If you wanted to go 1 column left, you would do -1. So that's all I'm gonna do. Just go select that cell to the right, and then we'll grab our image and put it in the cell. So let's now try this code and see what happens. So I'm gonna go back here. I have these two selected. So I'll go under macros, run this thing. May take a second here. So it went to that page, it generated this URLs, and it's gonna place QR codes here in our boxes. I'm gonna delete these two, and I'm gonna add one more thing to this. So since I'm gonna be using this data here, I want to URL encode the data because there are some characters that should not actually appear in your URL. And for that reason, instead of just doing cell.value, I'm gonna do worksheet function. And here, there should be a function URL, or maybe it's encode. Let's see. ABCDE. There it is, encode URL. Open parentheses, and we still need the cell.value here. So basically what I'm doing here, instead of this cell value, I add this encode URL function to make sure that any characters that should be converted to valid characters in the URL are converted right there. And that should be all we need as far as our macro. If you want to rename this to some other name, you can rename this. Just make sure no spaces, no special characters. I could call this add QR codes. Something like this. So at this point, I should be able to just go back to my spreadsheet, select as much as I want here. Let's say around this much. And basically just run my macro. And if I give it enough time, as you can see, it's gonna generate all of those QR codes right here. So that's pretty much all we need to make this happen. One last thing I'm gonna do here, because it's possible when you generate a bunch of QR codes like this, you may want to just delete all of these and repopulate them because something is not accurate for some reason. If you keep it like this, you would have to basically just select all of these images one by one and delete them. So what we can do, we can go back to our code editor and I'm gonna add a little bit of code here. So we're gonna do sub remove QR codes. Now, this is really just gonna remove every picture you have on that worksheet, so keep that in mind. So what I'll do, I'll just grab this part that says activesheet.pictures, copy that, and go here, and I'm gonna do for each pic, short for picture, in, and I'll paste that activesheet.pictures, and we're gonna do next pic to go to our next picture. And what we'll do, we'll just do pic.remove, or I think it should be delete, not remove. Let's actually type that correctly. Delete, yeah, it uppercased it. That's a good sign. So now if I go back to this, see I have some of these QR codes already here. I can go under macros and do remove QR codes, hit run, and see how it clears all of them for me so I don't have to go one by one and do this. And then obviously you could just go and highlight whichever ones you want to generate QR codes for, go under macros and run your previous macro to add your QR codes. and it should just go through them and basically populate those QR codes for you. And that should do it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.